Okay, next type of equation we want to solve are what we call the rational equations. So we want to solve rational equations, and I put here a little strategy. Most books, and in my book too, I say multiply both sides by the LCD. Just like, remember before we had some video on solving equations involving fractions. Well, for fractions, that was also the recommended approach, right? Whenever you see fractions in your equation, you want to kick them out as early as the first step, right? So you multiply by the LCD of the fractions. Well, rational expressions, so rational equations means you'll see rational expressions in your, what you call this, in your problem, right? So rational expressions look like fractions, so it's basically the same idea. You want to kick them out from the start, all right? So let's look at this simple example of a rational equation. You have 1 over y plus 1 over y minus 10 is equal to 12, all right? I have pretty simple denominators here, so if I do my align and drop, I really just need all of them, right? So the LCD will just be y times y minus 10 times 12, all of these three, okay? So according to this strategy, I multiply across the board by 12y, y minus 10. And when I multiply, I can distribute at the same time to each term, okay? Just to save space here. Multiply the left, but on the left, I have two terms. So those two terms will get the 12y and the y minus 10, each of them, right? Just like before. And then same thing here, you'll multiply this by 12y, y minus 10. Okay. So that's the very first thing, and let's see why it will, the goal is to get rid of the fractions or the denominators, okay? Well, if you look at this first thing, notice that the y with this y will cancel, all right? So therefore, you'll get 12 times the quantity y minus 10, denominator free, right? Denominator is 1. Plus, over here, you look at y minus 10 and y minus 10, those will cancel, right? These y minus 10s will cancel. You have a 1 times 12y. So 12y is by itself and no denominator, okay? Is equal to here, you'll have 12 and 12 will cancel. So you get y times y minus 10, okay? And that's the goal. And now once you see this, hopefully you know what to do, right? What do? When you have parentheses, you usually just want to get rid of them first, okay? So you distribute, so you get 12y minus 120 plus 12y is equal to, distribute this, you'll get y squared minus 10y, okay? You may want to simplify each side first. So here I see a 12y plus 12y, that will be a 24y minus 120, is equal to y squared minus 10y, okay? And now, you don't know what to do, right? And as I said, I always tell my students, if you don't know what to do, make one side equal to 0. And let's see, I can either make the right side 0 or the left side 0, but again, if I were you, I mean, this is what I usually do again, I look at that is a higher degree than these, right? So that's degree 2, so I'll just move these two terms to the right, okay? So do your exercise, okay? Carefully lift this over to the right side, make this equal to 0. And again, that means you subtract 24y from this side. So when you subtract from the left, you also subtract from the right, okay? Moving this over to the other side means adding 120, so you add 120 to that side, okay? And you simplify this. Let me see. Let's do it over here. So then you'll have 0 is equal to y squared minus 10 minus 24 is minus 34y plus 120, okay, equals 0. And you see that this is a degree 2 equation, so this is a quadratic equation. Quadratic equation, you have, I recommend, just think of two things you may do, okay, you can do. You can use either factoring, if it can be factored, or if you know how to factor, okay? Or you can use the quadratic formula, which some of you might prefer completing the square to the formula, but yeah, completing the square quadratic formula, the same thing, okay? Quadratic formula is a formula that came from completing the square. All right, so we'll try factoring. Oh, sorry, I did not teach you the strategy. So when you factor again, look at your cheat sheet, right? Cheat sheet is here, and I guess you see there are no GCFs. Count the terms, so it will fall under number 3. Number 3 is the sum product, okay? So you're thinking of two numbers that add up to negative 34 and multiply to 120, okay? 120 is a big number, so let's break it down. I see a 12 and a 10. I see a 3 and a 4. Well, I guess maybe I see it already. I don't even need to break down the 10. Do you see what I see? So it's 3 and 10 is 30, right, when you multiply. And then you have a 4. And I do want addition because that's a positive product, right? So I want two numbers that will add up to negative 34 and multiply to positive 120. So I see the 30 and the 4, and they both have to be negative because I want the sum to be negative. And so therefore, yeah, I think see that the left or the right side will factor into y minus 30, the quantity times the quantity y minus 4. And applying your zero factor property, you set each factor to zero. So you get for one possible answer, you have 30. The other possible answer is 4. Now, for rational equations, because of the nature of rational equations, they're kind of made up of fraction-looking things, right? Expressions, rational expressions. We have to be very careful. In the past, once we got these, we just circled, right? And we said, okay, I'm done. All right, those are my answers. Now, I have to explain to you what I mean in my book by excluded values, okay? We have to make sure that none of these guys are excluded, are not allowed to be in the answer, okay? What are excluded values? Well, again, if you look at this expression, sorry, it's kind of messy. The rational expressions I see here are 1 over y and 1 over y minus 10. These are the expressions that have variables in the denominator. 112 is fine. I'm not worried about 112. I'm just worried about these two, okay? Why am I worried about these two? Well, because whenever you have a rational expression, you want to make sure that you don't assign a value for y, in this case, that will make the denominator equal to 0, right? Remember in math, over 0 doesn't make sense. It's undefined. So we look here and we say, well, what values of y will make y equal to 0? So from here, this denominator, you don't want y to be 0. So we call y equals 0 an excluded value. In the back of the book, I call it EV, okay? Excluded value is 0, okay? Over here, you see y minus 10, and you say, well, what value of y may I not assign? I don't want y minus 10 to be 0. So you solve this little equation, right? Y minus 10 equals 0, and you get y equals 10 is another EV, okay? Another excluded value. So I have two excluded values from my, and I don't know if you watched the other video on the domain of definition. These guys don't make it, okay? They won't make it at all. We're not allowed to substitute 0 or 10 to y, okay? But fortunately for this problem, the two answers we got are 30 and 4, which are not excluded. We like them. They're okay, right? They 1 over 30 is good. 1 over 30 minus 10 is good. 1 over 4 is good. 1 over 4 minus 10 is good. They're not undefined, is what I mean, okay? So these are the possible answers for your rational equation. I'll give a few more. All right, next example, I have this huge rational equation, okay? So let's see. We might want to talk about excluded values first, so which ones are not going to be included, or you might want to find the LCD first. I don't know what you want to find. What you want to do? Well, these are not quite as simple as what I had earlier. In fact, yeah, maybe if you look at this, this is okay. I can't do anything about this anymore. This is prime, right? This is prime. But this looks like maybe I can factor, right? 2x squared plus 3x minus 2. If you look at your cheat sheet, it fits the mold of number 3, right? No GCFs, and it's three terms, 1, 2, 3, ax squared plus bx plus c. So you might want to do some your sum product, okay? So let's look at this. You want to look for two numbers that add up to 3 and multiply to AC, 2 times negative 2, okay? And of course, yeah, here this is actually an example where my students say, well, I can't break that down anymore and I don't see a 3 when I want to subtract. You might actually, in this case, want to work it out and make it as a negative 4, and maybe you'll see the 3, right? Because negative 4 can be broken down into what? Negative 4 and 1, or 4 and negative 1, whatever, right? One of them will have to be negative. So from 4 and 1, you see that there is hope. Let me make that bigger. 4 and 1, there is hope to get a 3 when you subtract, right? So your product is negative, so you want to subtract these two numbers to get the positive 3. And I guess we want a 4 and a negative 1, right? Now, this is the case where you have a leading coefficient of 2. So you have to do bottoms up here. You divide by 2, right? Okay? So 4 over 2 will reduce to 2. So the factored form will be x plus 2. And here you have a 2x minus 1. Okay? And in fact, we're happy because these two factors are really exactly these two guys that we have over here. Okay? We're not always going to be that lucky, but for this example, it so happens that these will factor into these two things. Okay? So, just copy that. Okay? I'll erase it. I need a space. Okay? So, it turns out that this denominator here, on your paper, you have to write this as your next step, okay? So I was just, because I don't have room. So then you will have x plus 2 times the quantity 2x minus 1. So the original problem can be written like this, where the last denominator is in factored form this time, okay? This is your second step, by the way, if you're showing your work on your test. Okay, so now we have these, okay, denominators. And we can talk of our excluded values, or EVs, okay? We want to make sure, maybe up front, that we know who are the answers that we might get that are excluded from, you know, being considered as answered. Okay, and what we said was, we don't want numbers, that we don't want to substitute numbers that will make the denominator 0. First denominator I have here is x plus 2. We don't want that to be 0, okay? And if x plus 2 is 0, then we say, well, then we don't want negative 2 to be substituted for x. So negative 2 cannot make it, all right, if ever we get that answer. The other excluded value will come from the second factor, right, the 2x minus 1, or the second denominator. We don't want 2x minus 1 to ever become 0 when we substitute an x, okay, a value for x. And, you know, this is a simple linear equation. Add 1 to both sides. So you get 2x is 1. Divide by 2, so you get x is a half, right? So you say, well, then the other excluded value is x equals a half, all right? So we have our two EVs, okay? So when you look at the back of the book, I put their EV, our 2, negative 2, and 1 half, all right? So hopefully you understood that. If not, rewind the video. Okay, so you set each denominator to 0. Sorry, I keep erasing, but I need a room. So let me just remember these two numbers. These are my excluded values, negative 2 and 1 half. And this is how I write it. Okay, so this is what you'll have. So those are excluded. We don't want them. All right. So now we're ready to do our solving, actual solving. So again, I said the strategy is to kick out these denominators, okay, by multiplying across the board by the LCD. And hopefully, you all can see how, what the LCD will be. First denominator is x plus 2. Second denominator is 2x minus 1 that has nothing to do, nothing in common with x plus 2 as a, in a factor, right? So these are two different types. The third is just these two together, right? So obviously the LCD will be both of them, right? The quantity x plus 2 times the quantity 2x minus 1. I hope that's clear, okay? So then what do we do with this LCD? We multiply this LCD to the left as well as to the right of the equation, all right? Now again, to save space, because on the left, let me erase this example too. On the left, I basically have 1 minus 2. I have two things, right? So I'm going to multiply that LCD 2 times on the left, okay? So let me put that one here. So see these two red things, I multiply twice because at the same time I'm multiplying to the left, I distribute to the two terms, okay? Now on the right here, I don't know if you see that one there, I have a one here minus this, okay? So again on the right, I really have two things, okay? Two terms that will get multiplied by x plus 2 to x minus 1. And I do this also for this. I hope you see that, okay? So you have that. And then now we try to clean up our equation. That was the goal, right? Why you multiplied by the LCDs so that your next step will look like a very nice, you know, denominator-free equation. Okay, so let's see what happens here. If you have this times this, you see that the x plus 2s will cancel, right? And so then what's left? Let me switch the order here. You'll have a 2x times a 2x minus 1, that quantity. You see that? Okay. For this second part, I see that the 2x minus 1s will cancel, right? So what I'm left with is what? Minus 4 times the quantity x plus 2. Okay? Equals. On the right side, I have 1 times those 2, so let's just keep that. Okay? That's for this. And then minus x plus 2 will cancel, 2x minus 1 will cancel, so the only thing left really is the 10. Okay? So that's what you have. Then look at what we have now, and again we see an equation that has a bunch of parentheses, right? So strategy when you see symbols of grouping is get rid of them, right? Okay? Get rid of your symbols of grouping by distributing. 2x times 2x is 4x squared, 2x times negative 1 is minus 2x, okay? Distribute the negative 4, so you'll get negative 4x minus 8 is equal to, I guess you guys will say FOIL for this one, right? So when you do FOIL on this, you'll get 2x squared plus 2x minus x. Let's do it, oh no, not 2x, sorry, that's 4x, right? Okay, so this is 4x and this is minus x. 4x minus x is going to be 3x. Okay, so that's going to be 4x minus x is 3x. 2 times negative 1 is negative 2, and then you have your minus 10. Okay, and now you see a bunch, these are, you know, a bunch of terms probably that we can compress on each side. So let us first combine like terms on each side of the equal sign. So here you'll have 4x squared minus 2x minus 4x is minus 6x minus 8. Okay, and then you'll have 2x squared plus 3x. I see that I can combine negative 2 and negative 10. I'm sorry, that's going to be a negative 12. Okay, so this is what I have right now. I'm running out of room. Okay, now what do we do? Again, when you don't know what to do, just make one side equal to 0. And I see here, if I were to do this, I'm going to make the right side equal to 0. I'm going to carefully move 1, 2, 3 terms on the left. See, that's a good workout for us, right? Okay, so move the 2x squared over to this side. That's really the same as saying you subtract 2x squared from both sides, right? Let me clean this up, okay? So you have this. Is going to look like what? 2x squared, okay? You move the plus 3x from the right to the left. It's really the same as saying you subtract 3x from both sides. Negative 6x minus 3x is negative 9x, okay? Move the negative 12 over to the left is really the same as adding 12 to both sides. Okay, so you'll have negative 8 plus 12 is positive 4. All of these guys here will disappear, so the right side is 0. Okay, and now you look at what you have. 2x squared minus 9x plus 4. Hopefully by now you know, oh, this is something that we can what? Probably factor, or those of you who don't like factoring can use the quadratic formula. I think we can factor this. So 1, 2, 3 terms, this is trinomial square, right? Or quadratic trinomial. This is your sum product, okay? You're looking for two numbers that add up to negative 9 and multiply to 2 times 4, all right? And again, this is one problem where I think it's easier to see it multiplied out rather than broken down as 2 times 4. I think it's better if you make 2 times 4 an 8, right? Now you're looking for 2 factors of 8 that will add. How come I know it's addition? Because this is a positive product, right? So I want those two numbers to add up to a negative 9. And 8, don't forget, you can break down 8 as itself in 1, right? So you can break this down as 8 times 1, all right? So therefore, you have 8 and 1. You want to add to get negative 9. So therefore, you need both numbers to be negative, right? Okay? Now, don't forget that because you had a multiplier, this A, 2, 4, that you have to divide both numbers by 2. We're doing bottoms up, all right? So you have negative 1 half is good. We like that. And negative 8 over 2 is not quite good yet. We have to reduce it, okay? So we have this, negative 4 and negative 1 half. So therefore, the factored form of this expression on the left is x minus 4, right? Do bottoms up here, you get 2x minus 1, okay? Equals 0. Okay, let's see. I'm running out of space. Let's move it over here. So here, using your zero factor property, you see that you set x minus 4 to 0, right? And the other one is, the other factor is you set 2x minus 1 to 0. Let me just, first one, you get x is 4, right? For the second one, you get 2x is 1 or x is 1 half. So right now, these are the two answers we have. These are the AVs, right? Negative 2 and 1 half. And right now, let me just circle these, although I'm not sure yet if I like both of them, okay? Just want to focus. I have these are excluded values, and I got these two answers, 4 and 1 half. So what do you say? Do I want both of them? Well, you see that 1 half was excluded from the beginning, right? And I got it for an answer, so really, I really don't want that answer because it's excluded. We already figured out why, right? It will make a denominator or two denominators zero. So I don't want 1 half. That's excluded, okay? It's an extra answer I got that I don't really want, all right? So the only thing that I really care about for this problem is x equals 4. So in the back of the book, you'll see me say SS, solution set, will just be the number 4, okay? Because I kicked out 1 half because we excluded it from the top, okay? From the very beginning of the problem. Hope that's clear.